Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Beth, I am obsessed with capacities and I want to help you also be obsessed with the capacities. One thing that was difficult for me when I first got started was understanding what a select property was and how the fixed sets worked. So I wanted to do this quick reference video here to walk through it and to give you something to look at whilst you're building your space. So the point of a select property is that it creates a connection or relation, if you're coming from Notion, that is a term you could use here, between two objects. We're going to be referring to those as object A and object B. And these connections are not in the actual page itself, so with Capacties it's a network note-taking app. You want to be creating links between pieces of content, and you can do that from the database itself through properties or within the page. In the page you would use the at or the square brackets to create backlinks, but we are doing something slightly different here, and that is creating connections within the database itself. So we're creating fields here, and we're saying that some of these fields are going to be connections to other apps. When we are doing this, there are a couple of questions we need to ask ourselves in order to set them up properly, and that's what I'm going to be walking us through here today. So I've put it into this flowchart, which will be available in the description and on my website and all of that for you to reference later. But we firstly need to choose the two objects that we're connecting. So we need to choose object A and B. I'm going to give the example of, in most cases, I think the media database linking to others. So my media is going to be object A. So let's hop into the media database and show you. So I've opened the object settings of my media database. This is object A. I already have a lot of select properties, and the way you can tell is because they are labeled with object B essentially. So I've got loads of tags, a couple of people, and so on. The first question you need to ask yourself is, how many pieces of data do you want to connect to in object B? So here, how many ratings do I want to find in tag, status in tag, media type in tag, or how many people do I want to relate this media entry to in the people database? Now the answer for this is either going to be one, or it's going to be multiple, either multiple outright right now at the point you've created it, or multiple at some point in the future. We've got a couple of examples of those here. So if the answer is one, you want a single select. You're saying, I want this property to relate to precisely one thing in object B. And if I hop into rating, that's what we're going to see. I've said that object A, media, relates to object B, tag, and I want a single select. I want one rating. Something can't be both 3 and 4 star. It's either one or the other. Conversely, with related people, I'm saying this piece of media talks about many people. Therefore, to sort of translate that into the property, I need to relate it to an object, which I've done here for the person, and I'm saying it's relating to... I'm giving it the opportunity to relate to more than one person, therefore I'm going to give it a multi-select. So that's the difference. How many things do you want it to relate to? One, single, more than one, multi-select. But then you can see below, the next question is, are we enabling a fixed set? A fixed set is just a subsection. So if I go back to the flowchart I made, when linking, do you want to choose from all of the content in object B or just a smaller selection or a subsection? If it is a smaller selection, you do want to choose fixed set. If you want to say nope, you can relate to whatever you would like within this object, it's no fixed set needed. So I'm back in my object, and if I go back into rating, you'll see again I'm relating to the tag on a single select basis, but I have defined a fixed set. It's related to my tag database, but I don't want to be able to rate something living room, which is a tag that I have because I like to collect home inspiration and capacities. I don't want it to relate to a tag called film or TV series. I only want it to look at my ratings, which I have handily put in a collection already. So what you can do is you can take this like predefined set of tags and put them into the media database. And now if I open a new piece of media and go to rating, it only shows me those bits. Now setting that up is not difficult. You either, so once you've set up the actual property by clicking fixed set, you can come into either the table view or in here and click content picker. If you've set the collection already, you can filter for collection and add these in one by one. It's a bit fiddly to start, but once you've set it up, it's set up, and that's nice and easy. Media is a similar situation where I have chosen a tag and I have chosen a fixed set, which I have set up in the same way by using my predefined media subsection of my tag database. But what I've done is I've said it's a multi-select. So I'm saying you can only pick from these options here, but you can pick multiple. And the reason for that is simple, and that is The Wolf of Wall Street. I was doing some thinking about that, and I realised it's both a film and a book, and I would typically just write about them all in one and sort of compare and contrast in that situation. There's a few things like that, you know, things that are books that are made into TV series or whatever. So this is a situation where you can logically use a fixed set for sort of ease and sort of streamlining your workflow a little bit rather than having to search through all of your tags. But you are saying actually you can have more than one media type here. So that's how you would use the fixed sets. And that answers this essentially. You just choose how many things you want to connect, and of those things you're connecting, do you want to see everything on offer or just a little bit? So if we've looked at the fixed sets, obviously the no fixed set life is a lot more sort of flexible and fluid. The most flexible and fluid option you're going to get is when you have something as simple as what historical events does this piece of media relate to? Obviously you could consume a vast number of like films and books, and that could relate to a vast number of historical periods. Therefore I would in that situation choose multi-select and no fixed set. Similar with the people connection you just saw in the media database, I could watch a vast amount of films that feature a vast number of people. So let's not put any sort of parameters in place. Let's just say connect to multiple things if you want from anyone in the people database. The one that is the least used in my own personal use cases is a single select, no fixed set. Most of my single selects are used with a fixed set, like with rating, status, priority and whatnot. The one place I have a single select without a fixed set, it's very difficult to say that fast, is in my places database. If we go to Angers, where I used to live, we will see an example. So Angers belongs to one country, and that's France. So if I open up this property setting, you can see that I have chosen object B to be the country's object, and I'm saying you belong to one country, so you've got a single set. But I don't need a fixed set because obviously everything that belongs in the country's database is a country. So it's just kind of already like a fixed set in essence. So yeah, that is how I would use each of the options that you have there. But whilst the terminology between apps can be a bit tricky to get used to, if you have used Notion, these are just relations and this is just a certain way of setting them up. You can do this exact functionality in Notion as well. You can restrict how many things you can relate between databases, and this is the same thing. You just set it up kind of in a different way through the object settings. But yeah, you say you've got two questions to ask yourself when setting up relations between databases. That is, how many pieces of content do you want to connect, and do you want to have free choice when connecting, or do you want to restrict it a little bit? The final thing I would say as like a reason for why you should put select properties in is contextual links. When you are looking at the graph of something, you can see that the lines between the links are labeled. You can imagine on a bigger scale, as we're adding more and more things in, it's very useful to have the connections labeled. So in a nutshell, use single selects, multi-selects, fixed sets and sets in the ways that suit the information that you're trying to track. It gives you a very cool graph and it is genuinely useful. So I hope that was helpful. Let me know if you've got any questions below, or if there's any other like quick tip videos that would be useful for you. I'll put the infographic in a link in the description. And if you're interested in Capacities overall and like deep dives into more of its features, I have just launched a course with Francesco from Keep Productive, and I'll put the link to purchase that down below. So thank you so much for watching. I hope this was helpful, and I will see you in the next video.